Hello, in this video I will show you how to implement internalization in Next.js. We will cover how to add a language switcher, dynamically translate pages, and even update our page titles based on the selected language. Plus, I will show you how to set up your Next.js build to export these pages statically. Part 1. Initial setup. We will start by adding next-intl library. With this library, we can handle internalization in the app router. Once it's installed, we will create the next.config.mjs file. Inside that file, we will wrap our next.config with create next-intl plugin. I recommend adding the type annotation to your next.config for type checks. We will create a messages folder. This folder will include our translations for each language. For this demo, I will use English and German languages. For now, we can leave those files empty. Next, we will create the config.ts file. This file will include our localizations. We will create the i18n.ts file under the source folder. The file location is important. If you want to create it elsewhere, you will need additional configuration. Inside the i18n file, we will import our locales and export the getRequestConfig function. This function will do two things. If the locale is unknown, it will return a not found page. If the locale is known, it will return the JSON. We will use the locale parameter to dynamically import the correct language. For redirections and remembering the current language, we need middleware. This file should be under the source folder as well. If you already have middleware and some logic inside it, you'll need to configure more. If not, you can use the create middleware function the library provides. We'll pass our locales to the middleware and set a default locale in case of an unknown locale is given. With the matcher, we are specifying on which paths the middleware will be called. Since we have English and German, we will call this middleware if the path starts with those languages or if the path is the root. After these configurations, we need to create a locale folder and move everything there. This locale folder will catch the language and pass it to our components. If you don't have a layout file, you should create it. Inside, we will access the locale parameter, get the messages and pass it to next-intl client provider. This provider gives us access to every translation on the client side. Also, we will pass the language probe to the HTML tag. Now we can translate our index page. Inside the English translation, let's create an object with the same name as our index page component and add the title. I will copy and paste it from the component. Inside the components, use the use translations hook to access the translations. You need to pass the key you want to access. In this example, the key will be index page. For the translation to work, we need to pass a key to the T function. Here we will pass title. Let's start our server and check if these configurations are correct. It seems that we are importing style.css inside the layout file, but it couldn't find it. We moved the layout file one level down, which is why the file couldn't find style.css. Okay, now the application is working and we are seeing exactly what we expected. If you check the URL bar, the n prefix is automatically added. This means our middleware is working. When I change n to d, the title breaks. In development mode, if a key is missing in a language, we see it like this. When we add the translation to the German JSON, everything returns to normal. Also, because of our middleware, even if I want to go to a path with no language prefix, it redirects me to the correct path. So it remembers the last language you preferred. Part 2. Rich formatting. We have a paragraph here with a piece that needs formatting. If you check the component, the code tag is used inside the paragraph. Let's copy the text and see how we can handle this. Just like before, we can use the T function and give the description as an argument. However, when we do that, the translation doesn't appear on the page. If you check the terminal, you can see we get a formatting error message. This is because our translation includes an HTML tag. If your translation includes an HTML tag, you cannot use the T function directly. You must use t.reach function. Right now we said, whenever you see a code tag inside the translation, render the code element. With t.reach, the translation appears on the page. This function is really powerful, as we can do whatever we want to this element, like adding a couple of classes. Also, I lied, you don't have to provide an HTML tag, you can name it whatever you want. If you name it example component like this, then inside the function call, you can access it as example component. So we are basically pairing the tag we put inside the translation with the element we want to render. Part 3. Navigation. When we want to go to another page in our application, we see this error. This is because from now on, we always need a language prefix. I can add the prefix to the navigation link like this, and it seems to be working. However, hard coding the language prefix like that is not ideal, as the user might be in a different locale. The next-intl library provides a convenient way to solve this problem. Inside our config file, let's create a couple of variables. We need the path names our application uses, and we will tell the library that we always want the locale prefix. Create a new file called navigation and import this long function. Import our configurations from the config file as well and pass them to the function. What this function basically does is it wraps the Next.js routing hooks and components. From now on, we must use these functions rather than the Next.js versions. So let's go to the navigation link component and replace the Next.js link component with our wrapper. Now, when we go to another path, the locale prefix is included. When I change the locale, the path's locale prefix changes as well.
Part 4. Eslint.
Ooh, I'm a new developer on this project. Let me add a link component here. Ooh, why there are two link components? As a Next.js pro, I know I must import the next link component. No problem, right? Oops. When a new developer joins or when you return to your project after a while, it might be hard to remember to always import from the navigation folder. To prevent this, we can include an Eslint error called no restricted imports. This error will be triggered when we want to import either the link component or the hooks related to navigation. When I try to import the next link now, Eslint throws an error and the build step will fail. When you replace the link with the wrapper, the Eslint error goes away.
Part 5. Locale Switcher.
I want to change the language as a user, but we don't have a select element here. Let's build that. First, create a component called Locale Switcher Select. Since this function will have an onClick handler, we will mark it as a client component. It will take children, default value, and label as props. We don't want to block the user when we are updating the page. That's why we will use the useTransition hook. In the onSelectChange function, we will get the next locale the user wants and start our transition. We want to keep the path name and params the same and change only the locale. Since path name and params always match for the current route, we can skip the runtime checks. The component will have a couple of tailwind classes, but it's basically a select component. Okay, now it's time to create the Locale Switcher component. The reason why we separated the components is we want this component to be a server component. Let's create the translations for this component. For German, the description translation is missing, so I filled that. We will use the useLocale hook to get the locale. Even though this component is a server component, we can call this hook. This approach enables us to create shared components that work both as client and server components. Import Locale Switcher Select component and paste the necessary props. We haven't created the label translation, so let's do that. We will map each available locale. But here's the thing. For each locale, we are using the same translation key. How will this work? In your translation files, you can add a bit of logic. If we add curly brackets, it means some logic will happen. I first type locale to indicate that this value will determine the final translation. Then I write the select argument. There are a couple of arguments like this you can use in the library. With the select argument, I will first give the key, then the value. The first key is D, and the value is German language. The second key is N, and the value is English language. If our locale is neither D or N, the final value will be unknown. So basically, if the value is D, return this. If the value is N, return this. And if not, return this. Let me copy paste the German translation as well. Just like in the t.reach function, we are passing the current locale to the function. And if you change the locale key here, you need to update the translation as well. Now the component is ready. We can add it to our navigation bar. Perfect. I can change the language. And when I refresh the page, it remembers the previous locale.
Part 6. Static rendering and page metadata.
Okay, I filled the missing translations for the project. Now everything you see on the page comes from our translation files. Yay, we have a cool website supporting internalization. But wait a minute. Look at our title. I mean, at least show the English title, man. This is not our only problem though. When I built the application, we see that our locale paths are dynamic. Next.js says that, bro, I don't know the possible locale, so I have to create it as we go. We must fix these two problems for better user experience. To create pages statically, go to the layout component and export the generate static params function. Inside that function, return your locales like this, so Next.js will know the possible locales during the build time. For updating the title, export the generate metadata function. This function has access to our locale, so we will get the translations using the get translations function. This function doesn't know which locale you want, so we have to give that and the namespace you want. Inside the locale layout namespace, we have a title in each language. If you return the translated title, the problem will be fixed. You need to call unstable set request locale function on every page and layout where you intend to enable static rendering. With this function, server components can access the locale param. Even if the function name states it's unstable, it's actually reliable. Unfortunately, there is no other way to do this at the moment, so don't forget to add it to every page and layout. After these changes, when I run the application, we see our title is changing depending on the language. And if I create a production build, we see that static pages are created for each locale available. Thanks for watching this video. If it helped, you can subscribe for more tutorials.